So today we are going to start with noun pronoun agreement, right? So how a noun and pronoun will agree with each other, that is what we are going to learn, right? So pronoun agreement, everyone should know their pronouns or his or her pronouns. So both of them, which are written in bold, right, are pronouns. Everyone is also a pronoun, there is also a pronoun, his or her pronoun, right? So the presentation covers agreement between pronoun and its antecedent, so the subject and its pronoun, whenever the agreement between them is covered in the noun pronoun agreement chapter. So a pronoun agreement item on an objective test might look like this. So, sample item I'm showing you here. Is the first there a person or the second there a problem? So, it might be a confusion for you, but here you can see spendthrifts are quickly parted from their money, right? So, this is the subject and this is the pronoun utilized here. So spendthrifts are quickly parted from their money. So a person who wants to start saving should not spend all of his time at the mall. So in the first there a person or second there a problem. The second there does not agree with a person. An error that choice C fixes. So should not spend all of his time at the mall. So C fixes the problem here. So the sample item here it is that the pronoun should agree with the subject of the or the antecedent of the sentence, right? So here you can see whenever I have utilized so a person, so it is a singular thing. So the pronoun is also utilized, which is singular, which is his. Spendthrifts was a plural thing, so the pronoun utilized here was plural. There is a plural pronoun. Here we have utilized a person, so the pronoun here utilized is singular, right? So agreement, what is agreement in nutshell? So I have given you one example. The kangaroo carries its joy in a pouch. So kangaroo is singular antecedent, so the pronoun is also singular because it is a singular pronoun, right? So here second, the kangaroos carry their joys in pouches. So here as the antecedent is what? It is plural. So the pronoun is also plural there, right? So know your pronoun. What are singular pronouns and which are plural pronouns? You should know. Singular pronoun is he, she, it, him, her, it, his, her, hers, its, himself, herself, itself. Plural pronouns are they, them, their, theirs, themselves, right? Those are plural pronouns. Now, two or more singular things when joined by and make a plural antecedent. Here you can see the new puppy and kitten have destroyed their owner's sofa. So here you have seen that there was a plural pronoun, right? So whenever it is written, the new puppy and kitten have destroyed their owner's sofa. So two antecedents, two or more singular things, right, when they are joined, they make a plural form, plural pronoun, plural antecedent, their owner's sofa, right? So remember that when two nouns are joined or two subjects are joined with conjunction and, then the pronoun will be plural. Here you can see when each or every precedes two or more singular thing joined by and, you have to use a singular antecedent. Here you can see each new puppy and kitten destroys its owner's sofa. So it is what? A singular antecedent has been utilized here, right? Here you can see in the graph, in the table, it was a singular pronoun, right? So it has been utilized because each has been utilized before the singular things, right? Each new puppy is a singular thing, and kitten is a singular thing, right? So whenever each is utilized and the things are joined, singular things are joined by and, utilize singular antecedent like its, right? So every new puppy and kitten destroys its owner's sofa. So here every is utilized. So each and every, when they are utilized before singular things which are joined by and, utilize singular antecedent. Now, in this situation, there is another situation. No matter how many singular nouns you join with and, the antecedent is still singular. See, each new puppy, comma, kitten, comma, rabbit, tarantula, python, parrot, turtle, and fret destroys its owner's sofa. So, no matter how many singular nouns you join with N and comma, the antecedent is always singular. Singular antecedent, here you can see it is singular. We have utilized it, each. And there are so many nouns which are joined here, which are singular nouns. Use caution with these there junction, either, or, neither, nor, and not only, and but also. So whenever you are utilizing neither, either, or, not only, what kind of pronoun you will utilize? So not only Lewis, but also Smee, also the Smiths fixed their famous squid eyeball stew for the picnic. So what is happening? So, whenever there are two nouns utilized in the sentence, right, and there is a pronoun which has to be utilized in the sentence, what happens? You consider the noun which is closest to the pronoun. Suppose your Smith is in plural form. So, the antecedent will also be in plural form. So, we have utilized there, right? So, whenever in the sentence you utilize not only either, use the pronoun according to the noun which is nearest to it, right? So here you can see not only Smith but also Lewis fixed her famous squid eye stew for the picnic. So here, as Lewis was in singular form, we have utilized singular antecedent. As here Smith's was in plural form, we have utilized plural antecedent. These indefinite pronouns are always singular, even when they seem plural. So here you can see each, either, anybody, anything, everyone, everybody, everything, no one, nobody, nothing, someone, somebody, something. These are all known as indefinite pronouns. Whenever you are utilizing indefinite pronoun, the antecedent is always singular. So everyone on the earth, so it is more than one person, billions of people we are talking about. The word everyone, however, is still singular, right? So remember that indefinite pronouns, the words are always singular. Here you can see. Be aware with interpreting phrases. Like here you can see, neither of my two brothers shows much sense when he dates women. So here you can see, neither of my two brothers is a prepositional phrase, right? Is equals to singular antecedent, right? So that's why we have utilized singular antecedent. He dates women. So neither of my two brothers, we have utilized neither before the sentence. Also, we have utilized a prepositional phrase. Right, so that's why what we'll be utilizing, we will be utilizing singular antecedent. He dates, right? Not them dates or they dates, right? So it is singular antecedent is utilized here. So neither of my brother shows much sense when he dates woman. So this prepositional phrase is taken as a singular thing, right? Company, organization, department, school names are always singular. One urban legend is that Tito Tech's place makes its burritos with kangaroo meat. So here the Tito Tech place is a company's name. So that's why the antecedent, it is what we have utilized, singular pronoun, right? So now we are going to take test, right? According to the whatever rules I have explained you, apply them and just give answer to the questions. So there will be different options, right? If there is no change, then tick the option of no change. Either you have to replace the error with the correct answer. Not only my brothers but also mom loves to drench their omelets in ketchup. So do you think that the plural pronoun should be utilized? We have utilized not only here. So think about it. What should be utilized here? His, her, his and her, or no change is necessary. Not only my brothers but also mom loves to drench her omelets in ketchup, right? So her is the correct answer. A singular pronoun will be utilized because the word mom was singular, right? So that's why. Okay, here, second question. The student and their professor sweated in the hot classroom. Right, the students and their professor sweated in the hot classroom. Each one of them wondered why they have decided to commit to summer school. So, first pronoun in is utilized, which is there. Second, in the second sentence, we have utilized each one of them. And according to that, we have utilized pronoun they. What will be the answer? The students and their professor, here the thing is correct because this is in plural form. So, plural pronoun has been utilized. Student and their professor sweated in the hot classroom. Each one of them wondered why she had decided to commit to summer school, right? Each, according to the rule which we have studied, this indefinite pronouns are always singular even when they seem plural. Each. So, singular she we have to utilize, right? So, she had to decide, why she had to decide to commit to summer school, right? So, she is correct. Rather than they. Next example. Robert and Sue Ellen concentrated on the dead worm on the dissection tray. They used tweezers to pick through innards looking for the heart. Right? So, they. What we have, he used, we have to utilize. She used, we have to utilize. Or there is no change. He or she, we can utilize. What we can do. So, Robert and Sue concentrated on the dead worm on the dissection tray. They used tweezers to pick through innards looking for the heart. So answer will be, Robert and Sue concentrated on the dead worm on the dissection tray. They is the correct form of pronoun which is utilized, right? So they used tweezers to pick through innards looking for the heart, right? So plural form of pronoun is utilized here. Because the tweezers, with the word tweezer, is also in plural form, right? Now, fourth question. The students have decided to eat at Tito's Taco Place where they can order their special, their discount burrito and soda will satisfy hunger and its cheap prices will help wallets. Now, do you think there is any change which is required in A, B and C? Right? Read the sentence again. Think about it. What rules can be applied? Right? And then do the changes. So, see here. The students have decided to eat at TikTok's Palace. Tito Taco Palace, where they can order the special. Its discount burrito and soda will satisfy hunger. Burrito and soda, here you can see, I'll explain you by the rule. See, in this situation, how many singular nouns you join with N, the antecedent is still singular. So, here, their discount burrito and soda. So, burrito is also singular, soda is also singular. So, here, the B option, that will also be singular. Its discount burrito and soda will satisfy hunger and its cheap price will help wallet. Right, so here the only change which we have is it should be utilized here, right? Okay, now next is either of these thick books by respected authors will have the answer to your research question in their many pages. So as we have utilized either here, we have to utilize singular pronoun its. Fine. So whenever either, neither is utilized, you utilize singular pronoun. If everyone's the sixth question is, if everyone stopped to smell the roses, they might get stung by bees and have their allergies kick into overdrive. So we have utilized everyone here, right? So if everyone stopped to smell the roses, they might get stung by the bees and have their allergies kick into overdrive. So is there any change which is required here? So if people stop to smell the roses, they might get stung by the bees and have their allergies kick into overdrive, right? So as using everyone, you utilize people. If people stop to smell the roses, because both the words which we have utilized are plural pronoun, they and their. So instead of using everyone, right, that will be a singular thing. Rather than utilizing everyone, you utilize people. So the whole sentence framing is correct, right? So here you should not utilize everyone, you should utilize people for plural form of sentence. Okay, here the next question is, Weaver Hill High has strange school colors. Their hot pink and bright yellow combination really stands out on the field, right? So Weaver Hill High has strange school colors. Their hot pink and bright yellow combination really stands out the field. So what do you think? What will be the answer? So here the answer will be its, right? Weaver Hill High has strange color. Its hot pink and bright yellow combination really stands out on the field. We have to utilize its rather than utilizing their, because as told earlier, no matter how many nouns you join through end, but the end, pronoun is always singular with those nouns. So its we have to utilize. Now, next question is, Sam is starving and his buddies have just ordered their upsized meals, right? Despite Sam's drooling, neither of them will part their French fries. So, is there any change required? Sam is starving and his buddies have just ordered his. What can be utilized here in option A? Despite Sam's drooling, neither of them in option B, what can be utilized from these three options? Will part their friend with their French fries. So option A, B, C. What can we utilize from this? Just think about it. So see here that in option C, we can utilize his. Sam is starving and his buddies have just ordered their upsized meals, right? Here this is plural. That's why we have utilized plural pronoun. Despite Sam's drooling, neither of them will part his French fries. So here, the Sam's is also in plural form. So that's why we have utilized them, right? Will part his French fries rather than their French fries, because we have utilized neither, right? So that's why we'll utilize his here. Slide refuses to return. Next question is, Slide refuses to return to the weight room because its staff always pokes fun of his skinny arms and leg. There, his, her. What can we utilize? Is there any change? Slide refuses to return to the weight room because its staff always pokes fun of his skinny arms and legs. What can we utilize here? As here, what is happening? Slide refuses to return to the weight room because its staff always pokes fun of his skinny arms and legs. So they are talking about different things and they are connected by end. But as we know, even if different, they are talking about different things, we can utilize singular pronoun here, right? Not plural pronoun. Next is, everyone should memorize a Shakespeare monologue for Miss Smith because the extra credit points will help them improve their averages at the end of the semester. Right? So, everyone, them, there, what can be the change? Just read the sentence carefully. Can we utilize the students anywhere? In B, can we utilize him or her? In C, can we utilize his or her? So in A, we have to utilize the student. The student should memorize a Shakespeare monologue, not everyone, right? The student should memorize a Shakespeare monologue for Miss Neath because the extra points will help them improve their averages. Okay? At the end of the semester. So only everyone can be replaced by the student. Because if we have utilized everyone, then the pronouns will be singular, right? Rather than doing that, we are replacing everyone with the student so that the pronoun utilized will be plural. So these were some questions about noun-pronoun agreement. Just go through all the questions to understand the rules in detail. Thank you.